ஹலோ, குட் மார்னிங். மை நேம் இஸ் ரமேஷ் ஹெச்ஜி, அசிஸ்டன்ட் ப்ரொஃபஸர் ஆஃப் மேத்மெட்டிக்ஸ், கவர்மெண்ட் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் எய்ட் காலேஜ், திப்டூர். டுடே ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு எக்ஸ்பிளைன் எக்ஸாக்ட் டிஃப்ரென்ஷியல் ஈக்குவேஷன்ஸ், ஹவு டு சால்வ் தீஸ் டைப் ஆஃப் எக்ஸாக்ட் டிஃப்ரென்ஷியல் ஈக்குவேஷன்ஸ். ஸோ ஃபஸ்ட், இன்டிகிரேட்டிங் ஃபேக்டர். கன்சிடர் த டிஃப்ரென்ஷியல் ஈக்குவேஷன் ஒய் இன்டூ 2xy plus 1 into dx minus x into dy is equal to 0. This is of the form m dx plus n dy is equal to 0. Here m is y into 2xy plus 1 and n is equal to x. Now we have to differentiate m and n, m with respect to y and n with respect to x. So, dou m by dou y is equal to, it becomes 4xy plus 1, and dou n by dou x equal to 1. So, we observe that dou m by dou y is not equal to dou n by dou x, and hence this is not an exact differential equation. So, you see that the given equation is y into 2xy plus 1 dx minus x into dy is equal to 0. Here m is 2xy square plus y and n is minus x. We see that dou m by dou y is 4xy plus 1 and dou n by dou x is minus 1. We observe that the equation dou m by dou y is not equal to dou n by dou x, and thus the given equation is not a differential equation. So, how to convert this into exact differential equation? Suppose we multiply the given equation by 1 by y square term. Suppose we multiply the given equation by 1 by y square. So, this 1 by y square is called as an integrating factor. We call it as integrating factor. So, if you multiply this equation, it becomes 2x plus 1 by y into dx minus x by y square into dy is equal to 0. So, after multiplying the given equation by 1 by y square, we get 2x plus 1 by y into dx minus x by y square into dy is equal to 0. Now, we have to check this equation for exactness. So, is it exact or not? How to check this equation as exact? So, m is equal to 2x plus 1 by y and n is equal to minus x by y square. So, dou m by dou y is equal to, one by y square minus 1 by y square, and dou n by dou x is equal to minus 1 by y square. So, after differentiating the terms with respect to y and x, we get to minus 1 by y square and minus 1 by y square. So, clearly they are equal, and hence this equation is exact differential equation. So, you see that the given equation is exact differential equation. Okay. So, here 1 by y square, we call it as an integrating factor. Is exact. Now, the equation 2 can be written as, so equation 2 can be written as 2x dx plus y into dx minus x into dy divided by y square is equal to 0. So, this can be written as derivative of x square plus derivative of x by y is equal to 0. So, this equation can be written as derivative of x square plus derivative of x by y is equal to 0. So, on integrating, we get x square plus x by y is equal to c. So, which is the solution of the given differential equation? In the above example, we observe that multiplying the equation, which is not exact, by a factor, we made it exact. So, the given equation is not exact, but multiplying the given equation by some term or factor, then the equation becomes exact equation. we can find in several cases such factors and make the non-exact equation to be exact. Such terms or factors are called integrating factor of the equations. We should give a formal definition. So you observe that the given equation is not exact differential equation, but by multiplying the given equation by some term or factor, and the equation becomes exact equation, and such terms are called as integrating factors. So how to find these type of integrating factors? We shall give a formal definition. If the equation mdx plus ndy is equal to 0 or pdx plus pdy is equal to 0 is not exact equation, then f of x comma y p dx plus f of x comma y q into dy is equal to 0 is exact. Then the multiplicating factor, that is f of x y, is called an integrating factor of the equation. It's called integrating factor of the equation. We have seen that the function e to the power of integral of pdx acts as an integrating factor in the linear equation dy by dx plus p into y is equal to 0. So we have different methods to determine suitable integrating factors. We shall see few sample rules to determine integrating factors without proof. So we give some formulas to find the integrating factors in such cases. So here we have several examples. So derivative of x by y, first formula, derivative of d by dx of x by y is equal to y into dx minus x into dy by y square. Derivative of y by x is x into dy minus y into dx by x square. Derivative of xy is equal to x into dy plus y into dx. Derivative of tan inverse x is equal to x into dy minus y into dx divided by x square plus y square. So you remember all these formula. Derivative of x by y is y dx minus x dy by y square. Derivative of y by x is equal to x dy minus y dx by x square. Derivative of x by y is equal to x dy plus y dx. Derivative of tan inverse y by x equal to x dy minus y dx by x square plus y square. Again, derivative of log of y by x is y dx minus x dy divided by x y. So these are the formulas. You have to remember all these formulas. So you take some examples, problems. Solve y into 2xy, y into 2xy plus 1 into dx minus x into dy is equal to 0. So given a differential equation, you observe that the given differential equation is not an exact differential equation. Given differential equation is not exact differential equation. So here m is y into 2xy plus 1 and n is minus x. Grouping the terms first. So the given differential equation is not exact differential equation. So you observe that dou m by dou y is not equal to dou n by dou x, simple. So it is not exact differential equation. First you have to group the terms. How to group the terms? We have now y dx minus x dy. So you multiply all the terms. So 2xy square dx plus y dx minus x dy is equal to 0. So you take y dx minus x dy one side plus 2xy square dx equal to 0 another side. Next, you divide the equation by y square. Divide the equation by y square. So this becomes y dx minus x dy divided by y square. That means this suggests that 1 by y square is an integrating factor. 1 by y square is an integrating factor. Multiply the given equation by 1 by y square. So you have to multiply the given equation by 1 by y square. Then the equation become exact differential equation. So y dx minus x dy divided by y square plus remaining is 2x dx equal to 0. Or derivative of x by y. Derivative of x by y. So, first term is, derivative of x by y by the formula. Plus derivative of x square is equal to 0. And integrating we have x by y plus x square is equal to c. After integration, the derivative of x by y becomes cancelled and remaining is x by y. Plus the derivative of x square cancel, so it becomes x square or x plus y x square equal to cy, which is the required solution for the given differential equation. So in this way we can find an integrating for non-exact equations. Then if you multiply the equation by integrating factor, this become exact equation, and grouping the terms and applying the derivatives, we can find the solution of the given differential equation. So second one, solve the differential equation y into x square plus y square minus 1 into dx plus x into x square plus y square plus 1 into dy is equal to 0. So the given equation is, you observe that this is not a exact differential equation. First of all, this is not an exact differential equation. So first we have to grouping the terms. So x dy positive term minus y dx plus x square plus y square into y dx plus x dy is equal to 0. So after multiplication we get the terms like this: x dy minus y dx plus x square plus y square into y dx plus x into dy is equal to 0. So here you observe that 1 by x square plus y square is an integrating factor. 1 by x square plus y square is an integrating factor. So multiply the equation by 1 by x square plus y square. Then we have x into dy minus y into dx divided by x square plus y square plus y dx plus x dy is equal to 0. So this is the grouping the terms. That is very important. Grouping the terms, first step, then find the integrating factor and then multiply the equation by the integrating factor. This is the second step. So the first term becomes the derivative of tan inverse y by x, the equation, plus derivative of x into y is equal to 0. So you remember the formulas. First term is derivative of tan inverse of y by x plus derivative of xy is equal to 0. And integrating, next step is integration. So integration, and then if you integrate, differentiation, integration cancel, and the remaining term is tan inverse y by x plus xy is equal to c. This is the complete solution of the given differential equation. So in this way we can find the solution of the non-exact equations and convert into exact equation, then find the solution. Next one, find suitable integrating factor and solve the equation. So 1 plus xy into y dx plus 1 minus xy into x dy is equal to 0. Solution. The given equation can be written as, first observe that the equation is not exact equation. First observe that the equation is not exact equation. You find m, what is m, what is n, dou m by dou y, dou n by dou x. Then you calculate, they are not equal. So the given equation is not exact differential equation. Not exact differential equation. So you multiply the terms or grouping the terms. X dy plus y dx plus xy into y dx minus x dy is equal to 0. So first term is, you observe that first term is derivative of xy plus xy into y dx minus x dy is equal to 0. So the equation contains derivative of xy. Thus multiplying the equation by the factor, which is a function of xy, will not alter the equation. Also we know that derivative of log of y by x equal to y dx minus x dy by xy. So you observe the term comes here. So multiply the whole equation by 1 by x square y square. So then we have take xy whole square as in 1 by xy whole square as an integrating factor. So multiply throughout by the 1 by xy whole square. So derivative of xy by xy whole square plus y dx minus x dy divided by xy is equal to 0. So the equation becomes like this. So you write first term as derivative of 1 by xy. plus derivative of log of x by y is equal to 0. So this is the method is called as grouping. Grouping and finding the integrative factor. So on integrating, differentiation cancel. So 1 by x y remaining plus log of x by y is equal to c, which is the general solution of the given differential equation. So in this way we can find, we can convert a non-exact differential equation into an exact differential equation by multiplying with a suitable integrating factor, suitable integrating factor. So session continued. So rules to determine integrating factors. So next rules to determine integrating factors. Now we shall see few rules to determine suitable integrating factors without proof. So we have to find some rules to determine suitable integrating factors. So first there are four rules actually. There are four rules. Rule one. So if M and N are homogeneous functions, M and N are homogeneous functions. You know what is homogeneous functions. So each term of the R f of x y is equal to x to the power of n into g of y by x, x by y. So this function is called as a homogeneous function. Okay. So if M and N are homogeneous functions of same degree, for example, x square plus y square is a homogeneous function of degree 2. X cube plus y cube is a homogeneous function of degree 3. X plus y, x minus y is a homogeneous function of degree 1. X square plus y square plus 2xy is a homogeneous function of degree 2, like that. So each term are equal degree. So if M and N are homogeneous functions of same degree, you observe that the term same degree. If M and N are homogeneous functions of same degree. And Mx plus Ny is not equal to 0. Mx plus Ny is not equal to 0. Then 1 by Mx plus Ny is, 1 by Mx plus Ny is an integrating factor. So this is one rule. If M and N are homogeneous functions of same degree and Mx plus Ny is not equal to 0, then 1 by Mx plus Ny is an integrating factor for the given differential equation. That is the rule. M and N are homogeneous functions of same degree. Observe that. And Mx plus Ny is not equal to 0, then 1 by Mx plus Ny is an integrating factor. Second term, rule 2. If 1 by n into dou m by dou y minus dou n by dou x is a function of x alone, you see, 1 by n, remember all the formulas. 1 by n into dou m by dou x minus dou n by dou y is a function of x alone, is a function of x alone, or constant it may be, then e to the power of integral of f of x or e to the power of integral of k into dx is an integrating factor. This is the second one. E to the power of integral of f of x dx or e to the power of integral of k into dx is an integrating factor for the differential equation mdx plus ndy is equal to 0. So this is second one. Third one. If 1 by m into dou n by dou x minus dou m by dou y, 1 by n in m into dou n by dou x minus dou m by dou y is a function of y alone or say constant, then e to the power of integral of f g of y into dy or e to the power of integral of k into dy is an integrating factor for the given differential equation mdx plus ndy is equal to 0. Rule 4. If the equation is in the form of f1 of xy into y dx plus f2 of xy into x dy is equal to 0, with m is equal to f1 xy into y and n is equal to x into f2 xy and mx minus ny is not equal to 0, mx minus ny is not equal to 0, then 1 by mx minus ny is an integrating factor. So these are some rules to find the integrating factor for non-exact equations. For example, first equation. Find the suitable integrating factor and solve the equation. xy dx minus x square plus 2y square dy is equal to 0. So xy into dx minus x square plus 2y square into dy is equal to 0. So you observe that this is a non-exact differential equation. So if you see m is equal to xy, my n is equal to minus x square plus 2y square, clearly m and n are homogeneous equation, and dou m by dou y is not equal to dou n by dou x. Clearly it is not an exact differential equation. And m is equal to xy, n is equal to minus x square plus 2y square. So mx plus ny, you have to calculate mx plus ny is equal to x square y minus x square y minus 2y cube is equal to minus 2y cube is not equal to 0. So this is important, not equal to 0. So they are all homogeneous functions of same degree, degree 2. And mx plus ny is not equal to 0. And then 1 by mx plus ny is an integrating factor. Observe that 1 by mx plus ny is an integrating factor. Thus, by rule 1, 1 by mx plus ny is equal to minus 1 by 2y cube is an integrating factor. Multiply the given equation by minus 1 by 2y cube, we get. So, minus x by 2y square dx plus x square by 2y cube plus 1 by y into dy. So, the equation converts into this form. So, here the equation becomes exact. So, non-exact becomes exact by multiplying here by the integrating factor minus 1 by 2y cube. So this is an exact equation. The equation can be, or you check it, maybe m is equal to n is equal to, and dou m by dou y, dou m by dou x, it becomes exact equation. The equation is can be written as 1 by y into dy minus x by 2y square dx minus x square by 2y cube dy is equal to 0, or grouping may be taken, and derivative of log y minus derivative of x square by 4y square is equal to 0. Grouping may be taken. Or simply integration of m dx y constant plus terms of n not containing x into dy is equal to c. That also we may calculate. Or this also may calculate. On integrating we get log y minus x square by 4y square is equal to c. This is the general solution of the given differential equation. So in this way you can find the integrating factor by using the rules 1, 2, 3, 4. Then multiply the given equation by the integrating factor and then convert into exact equation and then solve by grouping or direct method. Solve x square y minus x square y dx minus x cube plus y cube dy is equal to 0. Solution, here we have m is equal to x square y and n is equal to minus x cube plus y cube. But both are homogeneous functions. You observe that dou m by dou y is not equal to dou m by dou x. And hence this is not an exact differential equation. But here observe that both are homogeneous functions of same degree. So m is of homogeneous function of degree 3. N is also degree 3. Both are homogeneous. Both are same degree. So you can apply rule 1. You remember rule 1. So mx plus ny. What is mx plus ny? Is x cube y minus xy cube minus y to the power of 4 is equal to minus y to the power of 4 not equal to 0. So observe that is not equal to 0. Then by rule 1, 1 by mx plus ny is equal to minus 1 by y to the power of 4 is an integrating factor. So observe that this is an integrating factor. 1 by mx plus ny is equal to 1 minus 1 by y to the power of 4 is an integrating factor. Multiply the given equation by minus 1 by y to the power of 4, we get minus x square by y cube dx plus x cube by y to the power of 4 plus 1 by y dy is equal to 0. So after multiplying the equation by integrating factor minus 1 by y to the power of 4, we get the equation. So this equation is an exact differential equation. You may check or not, this is an exact equation. Consider integration of m dx, y is constant, minus y square, x square by y to the power of 3 dx. This is equal to minus x cube by 3y cube. Again, integration of terms of n not containing x into dy is equal to 1 by y into dy. So you observe that the term n, in which there are two terms, so 1 by y, x cube by y to the power of 4. So we have to omit the x cube by y to the power of 4 since it contains x. So 1 by y into dy is equal to log y. Hence, the solution is log y minus x cube by 3y cube is equal to c. This is the solution of the given differential equation. Example 3. Solve y into 8x minus 9y into dx plus 2x into x minus 3y into dy is equal to 0. Solution. Here m is equal to y into 8x minus 9y and n is equal to 2x into x minus 3y. Consider the equation dou m by dou y minus dou n by dou x. Are you observe that this is not a exact differential equation. So dou m by dou y, dou n by dou x is not equal. They are not equal and is not an exact equation. So here we observe that we may use the rule. We may use the rule, second rule. Second rule, dou m by dou y minus dou n by dou x is equal to dou m by dou y minus dou n by dou x is equal to 8x minus 18y minus 4x plus 6y is equal to 4 into x minus 3y. Now 1 by n into dou m by dou y minus dou n by dou x is equal to, so we apply the rule second, this is equal to 2 by x. So 2 by x, we got 2 by x is a function of x. This is a function of x. Therefore, the by rule 2, e to the power of integral of 2 by x dx is equal to e to the power of log of x square. Our x square is an integrating factor. So we easily find x square is an integrating factor. So multiply the given equation by x square. We have 8x cube y minus 9y square x square dx r plus 2x to the power of 4 minus 6x cube y into dy is equal to 0. This equation is exact equation. So after multiplying by the equation by the integrating factor, this equation become exact differential equation. The above equation can be regrouped as derivative of 2y x to the power of 4 minus derivative of 3y square x cube is equal to 0. On integration, we have 2y x to the power of 4 minus 3y square x cube is equal to c, or x square y into 2x minus 3y is equal to c. This is the required solution of the given differential equation. So in this way, we can find the solution of the non-exact differential equation. Solve xy into sin of xy plus cos of xy into y into dx plus xy sin of xy minus cos of xy into x dy is equal to 0. Solution. In this equation, m and n are in the form of m, this is rule 4. M and n are m into y into f1 of xy, n is x into f2 of xy, m is equal to xy sin of xy plus cos of xy into y, and n is xy sin of xy minus cos of xy into x. So here you observe that mx minus ny, what is mx minus ny? Mx minus ny is 2xy into cos of xy, which is not equal to 0. It is rule 4. Multiply the by rule 4, 1 by mx minus ny, 1 by 2xy cos xy is an integrating factor. So multiply the given equation by integrating factor. So multiply the given equation, we have, so this is y into tan of xy plus 1 by x into dx. After simplification, y into tan of xy plus 1 by x dx plus x into tan of xy minus 1 by y into dy is equal to 0. After simplification, we got the equation. This is an exact differential equation. You may check m is this one, n is this one, dou m by dou y, dou n by dou x. So they are become equal and this is exact differential equation. This is an exact differential equation, which is in the form of m1 dx plus n1 dy is equal to 0. Now integration of m1 dx, y constant plus terms of is equal to terms of, so this is equal to y tan xy plus 1 by x into dx. After integration, this is equal to y into 1 by y into log of secant of xy plus log of x. So our yy cancel, log of secant of xy plus log x. Again, terms of n not containing x into dx. So it is only one term, minus 1 by y into dy is equal to minus log of y. This is the solution. Hence, the solution is log of secant of xy plus log x minus log y is equal to log c, or x by y log of x by y. So you may cancel log on both sides. So this is x by y into secant of xy is equal to c. This is the solution of the given differential equation. So in this way, we can find the solution of non-exact differential equation. Solve 3x square y to the power of 4 plus 2xy into dx plus 2x cube y cube minus x square dy is equal to 0. So clearly m and n are, so dou m by dou y, dou m by dou x, they are not equal and is not a exact differential equation. First you have to check for exact equation, otherwise you will apply the formula. So dou m by dou y is not equal to dou m by dou x, and hence they are not equal, it is not an exact differential equation. Next come to the rule 1, 2, 3 or 4. So you calculate 1 by m into dou n by dou x minus 1 by dou m by dou y. So that is the second, third rule, rule 3. So this becomes minus 2 by y, it's a function of y alone, after simplification we get minus 2 by y, which is a function of y alone. By rule 3, e to the power of my integral of f of y into dy, so minus 2 by y into dy is equal to e to the power of minus 2 log of y, so this is 1 by y square is an integrating factor. So by calculating 1 by y as an integrating factor, you multiply the given equation by 1 by y square. So this equation becomes 3x square y square plus 2x 1 by y into dx plus 2x cube y minus x square y by x square by y square into dy is equal to 0. And rearranging these terms, we get 3x square y square dx plus 2x cube y dy plus 2x by y dx minus x square by y square dy is equal to 0. So derivative of x cube y square plus derivative of x square by y is equal to 0. On integrating we get x cube y square plus x square by y is equal to c, x cube y cube plus x square is equal to cy. This is the required solution of the given differential equation. So in this way we can find the integrating factor, then multiplication, then solution of the given non-exact differential equation. Solve x square y dx minus x cube plus y cube into dy is equal to 0. Solution: given x square y dx minus x cube plus y cube into dy is equal to 0. So m is equal to x square y, n is equal to minus x cube minus y cube. So dou m by dou y is equal to x square, dou n by dou x equal to minus 3x square. Dou m by dou y is not equal to dou n by dou x. So clearly this is a not exact differential equation. Further, m and n are homogeneous functions. And consider 1 by mx plus ny. So this is equal to first rule, 1 by x cube y minus y to the power of 4 is equal to minus 1 by y to the power of 4. So integrating factor is minus 1 by y to the power of 4. So multiply the given equation by minus 1 by y to the power of 4. So the equation becomes minus 1 by y to the power of 4. We get minus x square by y cube dx plus x cube by y to the power of 4 plus 1 by y into dy is equal to 0. So this becomes exact differential equation. So dou m by dou y is equal to 3x square by y to the power of 4. Dou m by dou y is equal to 3x square by y to the power of 4. Therefore, the equation is exact differential equation. So integration of m dx equal to minus x cube by 3y cube. Integration of n dy is equal to, so this is log y. The solution is minus x cube by 3y cube plus log y is equal to c. So adding these two terms, we get minus x cube by 3y cube plus log y is equal to c. So in this way you can find the solution of the non-exact differential equation. Thank you.